You may have seen our basic API scanning video, which shows off our open API or Swagger integration that was delivered in WebInspect 19.2. For more advanced API scanning scenarios, we're also releasing an integration with Postman. By passing in a sample Postman collection, WebInspect 19.2 can now handle advanced API scanning scenarios where complex authentication, workflow, and parameter requirements must be met. To get started, you'll need to install three things. First, you'll need to install Node.js version 10. Second, you'll need to install npm. And finally, you'll need to install the Newman command line Postman collection runner. First, let's download and install version 10 of Node.js. This will need to be installed on the machine where WebInspect and the WebInspect API are up and running. As you install Node, it'll give you options for installing the npm package manager as well as adding Node to your path. Go ahead and select those options. Node is a quick and easy install, but once it finishes, go to the command line and type node space dash v to confirm the version of Node that's installed and to confirm that it's up and running. With Node and npm installed, we can now browse out to the Postman site to get the string used to install Newman, which is the command line runner that WebInspect will use for running Postman collections. Here you can see the npm install command. I'll just copy that out and paste that into my command line. That will call npm, which will install Newman. It's very quick and easy install, only takes a few seconds, and it will be up and running and almost ready to start scanning using Postman collections. With Newman completed installing, we'll then enter Newman at the command line just to confirm that Newman has installed properly. With Newman installed, we'll want to add it to our path so that WebInspect can use it. You can see the path where Newman installed in my environment. I'll go to my system settings and then modify my system path environment variable to add that Newman install location so that WebInspect can then use it when starting Postman collection scans. With that work complete, we'll restart the system and then we'll start testing. We'll go ahead and log in and then open Postman to show you a sample Postman collection. I won't go through all the details of configuring the Postman collection, but we'll show you how to export this collection here. This sample collection uses the pet store API example, creates a pet, and then does a get on that pet that was created, and then does a delete. One thing to remember when you're using Postman is to always click the Save button before exporting your collection to make sure that you're getting the full complete state of that collection. And in this scenario, I've exported that collection. I've exported it to my desktop. And so now I'm ready to run this through the WebInspect API that's leveraging that Newman integration. So we'll switch over to the WebInspect API, access the API scanner endpoint and the Postman integration. I will choose a file, and then we'll choose that Postman collection that we exported just a moment ago. When I click try it now, this collection will be executed through Newman. The Postman command result will provide you with an indication of the requests that were run through Newman and their success rate. So total requests as well as any failed requests. And then the scan ID above can be used throughout the WebInspect API to do things like query the status of the scan or export the scan or even create reports for the scan. For this example, let's switch over to the WebInspect UI. We'll take a look at the scan that's been driven by that Postman collection that ran through WebInspect. We've captured parameters and we've begun auditing those parameters and detecting vulnerabilities for this application. And finally, make sure to access the WebInspect automation repository at github.com/fortify for sample automation scripts using the WebInspect APIs, including this Postman integration.